Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. A second down throw for Prescott.
25-yard line.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Gonna take a shot for Gallup. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 21. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
First and 10.
That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, the turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that. But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well. That interception early, they may rethink how they go about attacking.
And Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at their own 21. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. Up past the 25 to the 26. A gain of 5.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Second and 5 now. Brady going deep this time for Miller. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
But they certainly came out firing in this one. And while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
They come up now third and 5 following the incomplete pass. Now is Brady. Looking downfield for Godwin. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Lewis. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
Now Prescott. That one complete, Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, 59 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. Boy, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
And this one will not be handled. It's into the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. But they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. They'll run with Fournette. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
From midfield, here's Brady. He goes full extension, and he's got it. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 39. 11 yards there, first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, Brady. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Throwing again, Brady. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line. First quarter, and now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw four interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
They'll run on first down. Elliott, and he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there, and he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
On second and 9, Prescott. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Prescott from the gun, letting one fly deep for Cooper. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr.
And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
Pass intercepted. The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 37-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Buccaneers, nothing.
Second and 7.
You remember me? You remember me? Let's go, baby. Check.
A shotgun give to Fournette. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Brings up third.
Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Third down. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Dontari Poe marches in for the sack. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that? And Prescott, his third interception. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And he's going to get this on down to the 13-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Here's a give to Fournette. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line.
DeMarcus Lawrence.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and five at the Cowboys' 8-yard line.
A handoff to Fournette. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a third and 7. Here's Brady. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own 10-yard.
How about the big boys snagging one? You don't see that every week.
No, you don't. But a lot of them are just reliving their old dreams, going back to when they were in youth football and in high school. They didn't always play defensive line. Some of them actually handled the football. And you can see the flashback when he grabbed that one.
He's going to loft one deep over the middle. He's got a man complete. Past the 20. Touchdown, Cowboys. Two first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys are able to show off their quick strike ability.
This is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels, and that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield and really created a big play.
Yeah, you said jumbled. They were the definition of jumbled defensively. One play and into the end zone. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay.
And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. The Bucs on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and six. Operating from the gun, Brady looking downfield for Godwin. It's caught inside the 25. And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys' side of the field. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Let's go. Let's do this. LeSean McCoy, and a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Throwing on second and 8. Brady quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Now the Cowboys are going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Shotgun now for Brady. And he's got his tight end, Howard. It's a Buccaneer touchdown. O.J. Howard there to make the grab. And the Bucs are able to make this a close game again.
And that was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone. So give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a 2-for-1 without ever even giving up the football. No running room for Zeke on first down as he'll maybe get a yard out of that. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Prescott down. A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
A 2-yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
Prescott from the gun on third. Just keeping the play alive. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
On the throwaway.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Back deep, Jadon Mickens. And now a high kick here as they'll try to cover this one. Just a 25-yard punt. Not what he was hoping for by any stretch. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock.
Incomplete.
Here's second and 10.
Second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
The final shot before half for Brady. And he'll get that to Fournette, complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. Now a hit and a loose football. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception picked off by Jordan Lewis. But that one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. William Dellston. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10 from the gun. He'll hand this off. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Dak dropping this one off for Zeke. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
First down, Cowboys.
On first down, it's Elliott. That'll result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Brought down at the 18-yard line. 8 yards on the back.
Again, it's Elliott.
Second and 2.
And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
And this this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. They'll run for it with Pollard. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. Well, they deemed it four down territory, and they got 4 yards to pick up the first.
First down, Dallas.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. 10th carry now for Elliott. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
You're talking about closing in a hurry as a safety and run support. Not only did he get a good run in, he gave him a pretty good pop, too, and finished off the play behind the line of scrimmage.
Going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Yard line, second and 11. They go to Elliott again. And they get to him quickly here as he stops right around the 13. The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of 1 there.
Normally you play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4. Those three guys up front, the nose tackle, the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the night. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And it's now 21-7.
Buccaneers 7. Greg Zuerlein to kick off for Dallas.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And they will watch this one land in the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Brady now on first down. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And incomplete on the deep ball.
The I'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this, when I think the part of their plan was to hit them over the top with the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
Again on second down. Looking downfield for Godwin. And this is caught at the 20. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, 65 yards. And the Bucs have made this a one-score game.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this, and I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. Extra point up and good by Succop. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
At their own 26-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. And what do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time. And that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
And it's
fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. It's a gain of 4 there and gives him a new set of downs.
And the Cowboy first down.
They'll try and run some clock now with Elliott. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts, as he'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, second and 11. And now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. It's a big play for the Cowboys on third. 58 yards. First and goal and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So that...
She back got me.
Dead boy and be so you gotta go berserk.
Okay. Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and wanna see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then sometimes you need a foe, wanna keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that wanna keep you where you've been before. I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check. Not the sneakers, but the ones that make you watch your step. You change name, how about your respect? Give them more than what I can.
know, I sat down with my accountant. He said, I got good news and I got bad news.
Okay.
I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot.
Okay.
I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more.
Okay.
Look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but in front of bay. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay. But wait. Jugging on the main stage. Put the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacay. Meditate, hydrate. Protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. Whoa. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature.
Boss.
I don't want to seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle, pockets LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I want to see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that. It's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where your permit. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend. Not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe. Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see with your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line.
No lie,
stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space coupe with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit. I've been groomed from the womb. Came out of my mama with some running tennis shoes. Faster than the speed and bullet.
Nah, 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 it's cool, it's cool.
Don't play with it, play.
Say you're
so what you gon' do.
NFL is on EA Sports, and we are at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida.
With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Dallas Cowboys.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Here's the punter, Bradley Pinion, on to get us started. And off we go from Tampa.
Fielded in the end zone. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25.
so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch it work, watch it hate, watch them lurk, can't relate. Watch it stir, out the mud, out the dirt. Above the waters, in the murks, out the gate. On sight, red free, red tight. Set the bar, take flight. Yeah, I've been grinding since a young and they told me my timing was coming. I've been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame, get the money. I'm out in LA where it's sunny. I've been eating since a young and since we ain't have food in our tummy. The life was living and funny, but you cannot take nothing from me. Put that on my mama, my daughter, my cousin, my brother.
Play clock down to three, and we're going to get a timeout here. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
He was tackled at the 27.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. From the shotgun again to Elliott. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down. Third and short yardage, Prescott. Got an open man, the tight end, Jarwin. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. I ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a
different story.
Long night.
Brings up second and nine at the 45-yard line.
On second and nine, Prescott. Man open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
A second down throw for Prescott. And he's got Ezekiel Elliott. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
A gain of 14.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And some room to roam now. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. First down, and it's Pollard again. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and seven at the 13-yard line.
Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. Flushed out right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, and it'll bring up third down. It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on third down.
Yards to go.
Here's Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not.
Those are bad teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. Able to move the ball on that drive. Yes, just 3 points, but 4 first downs were in there.
Yeah, and you can look at it and feel pretty good about the whole thing and think, okay, this should continue throughout this ball game. On the flip side, if you're a defender, it's almost like, whew, we only gave up 3. They moved the ball on us pretty well.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. On the ground, this is Leonard Fournette. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up 2nd and 10 at the 25-yard line.
3-0 after 1 on EA Sports.
Cowboys 3, Buccaneers nothing.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. To throw, it's Brady. Dancing to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
They come up to the line now facing a 3rd and 10 after the incompletion. Brady. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up 4th. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's 4th down. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. Fielded just inside the 20. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10.
28-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
To throw on 2nd and 6, Prescott. And that's Elliott, complete. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. 23 yards the pickup there.
It's a gain of 23.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. If you're going to give them 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the 1st down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Brings up 2nd and 4.
And incomplete.
Prescott. I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 30. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. So first and 10 now from the 30. Throwing. Prescott. This to Jarwin. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 11 more on that one and another first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
Second quarter, 2 minutes remain. 3-0 our score. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do. 14-yard line. That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Ball at the 14 for second and 5. Now here's a whistle as flags come in. And we'll check out the call. Ooh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
A false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on second down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Oh, Prescott stripped.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as he'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And Zuerlein's kick is good. And they're able to double their lead just before half. It's 6-0. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
Offense set to begin their next possession. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Looking downfield for Godwin. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, 60 yards. And the Bucs are just an extra point away from grabbing the lead now.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post-grab?
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
A
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Under a minute to play here in the half. Time for a late drive.
It makes sense when you think about it. Hey, try and get a field goal. Give yourself a lead going into the half. But if you're going to do this, you better have supreme trust in your quarterback. Supreme trust in the guy who's going to handle the football. Because if you turn it over here, not only do you go in down at the half, you've given the momentum squarely to your opponent.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw, Prescott. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Here's Prescott. Trying to lay one up deep. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Whitehead. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Prescott's pass intercepted.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Or what do you think? You get the ball off the turnover near the middle of the field. You take a shot here on the first play?
You know I'm big on that. I love when I have great field position after a turnover. I feel like I might have a little bit off balance. I prefer to take a shot, but a lot of coaches will tell you you only do it if you trust the guy who's got the football in his hands. Meaning, if it's not there, he won't force it downfield and maybe turn it into an interception. He'll go to the check down, go to a second option, and go ahead and take the play that's in front of him.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. The Bucs with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. Taken in the end zone. Offense set to begin their next possession. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
They'll run it again with Fournette. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage.
He was brought down.
No gain on the player there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up in a 3rd and 9 situation. At one, and it's Brady. Open man is Howard, the tight end. And it's a fumble. And he's going to come up a bit short. He needed to get to the 35 for the first, but he only makes it to the 34. They'll go with a big bang for an end. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. A big roll of the dice on 4th and 1, but it pays off. They convert.
6-yard line.
The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer 1st down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. The second and 10 now as we roll along in the third quarter from Tampa.
Push him back. Push him back.
To throw again. Brady looking downfield for Godwin. This is caught inside the 15. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. It's a gain of 35. There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They go back to the ground with Jones. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage.
At the line of scrimmage.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. From the gun, it's Brady. He finds his tight end, Howard. That's complete. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. First down, Tampa's Brady hooks up with Howard. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line.
Brought down
from the 2 now, second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
Shotgun now for Brady. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. It's good, and now it's an 11-point lead, 17-6.
The score, Buccaneers 17, Cowboys 6.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Cowboys take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. Prescott from the gun. He's going to let it go again. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Yards to go.
Prescott now. A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. 14 yards, good for a Cowboy first down. Back now in Tampa. It's the Cowboys in possession of the football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Prescott looks to throw on first. That one complete to Elliott. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. 10 more there and another first down. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. And again, it's Prescott. his man complete over the middle. That's Elliott. And he's got this down to the 35. Give him back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down. First down, Prescott. Now he'll let it go deep left side.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Brady and the Bucks now with a first and 10 at the 31-yard line. He'll begin with a give to Fournette to start the drive. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Leighton Vander Esch. That is the play they needed in a two-score game here in the fourth quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. Following the interception, here's Prescott. Flushed out right. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. The give is to Elliott. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. The Cowboys on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. A pickup of 5 that time and a first down.
First down, Dallas.
So not quite a first and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. On 1st and 10, Prescott. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Ndamukong Suh with a sack. We've seen that a ton since he entered the league in 2010.
Second down.
To try again after the sack. Prescott. And it's caught. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. From 21 yards away. And the Cowboys have cut it to within a score. There's certainly some importance to this one now. After the touchdown, they could get this down to a field goal with a 2-point conversion. They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful.
Cowboys 14.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. 1-score game.
Man, if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chili on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. Because if there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. A gain of just 1 yard, but it's a first down.
And Brandon, this is where it pays to have a big back who can take over a football game, especially in the fourth quarter when you've got the lead. Your ability to not just wear people down, but close games out.
And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. They'll try and run some clock with Fournette. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Fournette, a first down carry. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. From the 47, it's second and five. And a five-yard gain gets him to the 42.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. He's got a first down and more inside the 30. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. A big game.
For the wins, came in a drop on the 10, now we on top once again, yeah, I had to tighten the plan, yeah, I got it right in the end.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we are at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. Here's the punter, Bradley Pinion, on to get us started. And off we go from Tampa. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
22-yard line.
First down throw for Prescott. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
An
aggressive play call to start this game. It backfired, but aggressive. No question about that.
Is that one of those statement calls? Trying to let you know that they're going to be aggressive right out of the gate. But that one hung up just a little bit too long. He made a nice play on the ball defensively and was able to pick it off.
Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10, just shy of the 30. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
He's brought down.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sip through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Snap will come from the 31 on second and 7. Now Brady. Looking downfield for Godwin. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin, 69 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead.
For the point after.
As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
This will make it into the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Gotta laugh that one off and not the ha-ha. That was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And this drive will start on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
Intercepted. The Bucs take over first and 10 at the 20-yard line.
So after the INT, it's Brady. He'll buy some time right. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Tom Brady with two first quarter touchdown passes. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. Not even 2 minutes into this football game, already we've had two scores.
You know how much I like to read about teams of old, right? The teams of yesteryear. There were some teams that were known as the point-a-minute teams. Well, obviously in a 60-minute game, that's 60-plus points. But two touchdowns in the first 2 minutes? My calculator doesn't operate that way.
And now on the other side, they better wake up. They haven't even gotten off the bus yet.
Fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
Take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. And boy, that one drops incomplete. But if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. To throw is Prescott. And Prescott, his third interception. Picked off by Andrew Adams. Pitch just sets him up beautifully right down near the goal line.
I remember being in a defensive meeting back when I was in college, and our defensive coordinator says, we're going to call this be who you are defense. D-linemen, you play the run. Linebackers, be aware of anything. And secondary, you play the pass. That way, you're all set, ready for whatever they put out there.
They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and that'll make it second and goal. Brady going to throw. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Cameron Brady there to make the grab as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Boy, these guys are off to the races, Charles. 20-0 already, extra point pending.
Yeah, you always hear that term, they just boat race someone. Heck, it's car race, motorcycle race, plane race, whatever you want. Right now, they are sprinting past them.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Their own 24-yard.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and which also.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off around the 41. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
Throw it in rotation. Yeah, I use a dub. I'ma win. I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, I'm turning knob. Can't resist. I'm incredible. Yeah, I came for the dollars. Call it vegetable. Then I did the dash. Can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash. Can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself. It's a solo mission. Running up the charts. I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating around here. I'm the GOAT, little man. And I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I'm with the Cavalier. Show no love. Got the confidence. No fear. I use a dub. I'ma win. I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah. A fool with this, yeah. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this, okay, yeah, yeah,
can I hit that?
Ready for this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these eyes ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my crew. Ain't no L.
I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Can I hit that?
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe, one to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that want to keep you where you've been before. But I can't go, no, I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check, not just